Here we go.
So how many of you guys know how long the bees have been around? Okay. So they've been around for approximately 125 million years, give or take a million or so. And over the past century, scientists have been exploring the world of bees and why the decline is so high. Okay, so just an overview of what I'm going to talk about. We're going to be talking about how and when they became an endangered species, and ways they help our planet, and ways to actually save them. Okay, so according to sosbees.org 2017, the first week of 2017, they were eight species of bees were declared endangered, according to greenpeace.org 2017. And this was due to the fact that we sprayed pesticides, which are chemicals that we use on our plants to kill insects, and also due to the fact of that we burn fossil fuels, which creates a climate change, and with the climate change, the bees start to disappear because, the shift in climate. And I'm gonna talk about, you guys are probably wondering, well, like, why are they so important? So, according to Bee Informed 2016, one in three bites of food we take is made possible by bees and different pollinators. So what the bees actually do is they go to each plant or crop, and they actually, it's not much effort, they just go to each one, and this helps them reproduce and make more plants and do all that stuff. And approximately one-third of crops need bees and pollinators. And how we can save the bees. So General Mills, according to Cheerios.com 2017, Honey Nut Cheerios and General Mills started a hashtag, Bring Back the Bees. And if you guys are familiar with the brand, it's Buzz the Bee on the box. Well, now if you go to like your local grocery store, you'll see some of the boxes don't have him anymore, so it's just blank like that. And what they're trying to promote is Bring Buzz Back. And they are actually giving out packets of seeds to all of their customers. So what you guys can actually do is go on Cheerios.com and just put in your shipping information, and they'll send you a free bag of seeds for you guys to plant around your area. Just basically, you're planting wildflowers, which will cause the bees to come, and it's gonna attract the bees. And you can also, if you're really dedicated, you can be a beekeeper. And bee kits actually start at $100. You don't waste that much money. And you can actually start keeping bees in your backyard with that. And finally, you can tell your friends. You can use the hashtag #BringBackTheBees, and it's important for us to spread this information and spread accurate information, because a lot of people don't know that, you know, there was even more than one kind of different species of bees. And let alone that there are eight now that are going extinct. And just to review what I talked about how they, when and how they were endangered, how they help save our planet, and how we can help. So something that you guys can definitely do, which I push a lot, is it's really easy. Just go on Cheerios.com. And basically, or you can also just Google it too, like Cheerios free seeds, and just go on it. It doesn't even cost anything, actually. It's free. So that's what's getting people to actually do it, is that it's free. And it's really easy, just spread them around. You can spread them around here, anywhere, like anywhere that there's soil, and help with that. So hopefully you guys leave here knowing a little bit more about how they became an endangered species, and ways that we can all help them get off the endangered species list as well.